the state, and that's why the government of President Moi was on our heels there, worse than even here. So we've done a lot. We've done a lot.
Apart from targeting those 14 million diaspora people, why do you think Kenyans will vote for you?
Well, Kenyans
being strangers, you know, essentially you are a stranger. Those many years they.
I've never been a stranger. We've had so many Kenyans who have been in this country from that particular time or in my absence, who have done a lot of nothing other than damaging this country in terms of corruption.
Yeah.
So if it says that if somebody has been away and is a stranger and somebody has been in the country not being a stranger and has damaged this country more, then you have a duty to come in and correct the misdeeds. And furthermore, I was not out of the country because I wanted to be there. I was out of the country because of my own security. The case I mentioned before, if you make your own research, you'll find out that a lot of witnesses have expired.
Yeah.
So I did not want to come in and expire during that particular time. And I thank the president for having given me this opportunity to come back and be a free man. Because if we didn't have this president, I don't know where this country would be today. The country's become very peaceful for us to come back, and that's why I came back. So answering your question, I'm not a stranger in this country. The umbilical cord and the placenta that came with me from my mother's womb was planted in this country. The fact that I was away without my wanting did not cut off that link between me and this nation. The fact that Jomo Kenyatta was away for so many years, 18 years in exile, did not cut off his link with this country. The fact that people like Mbio Koinange, who went to study abroad, were away for a long time, did not cut off link with this country. The fact that Nelson Mandela, who became the president of South Africa, was incarcerated for 27 years in prison, did not cut off links between him and South Africa. So the issue of cutting links or having been absent is very relevant at the moment. What is very important is, what can I do to bring changes in this
but
country?
Most of these people you mentioned, they're under critical mass behind them.
They had critical mass?
Critical mass, mm-hmm. People who were waiting and they knew they were there.
Yes.
And they were supporting, and they were making noises or whatever they were.
Mm.
You went and studied law.
Right.
And you have done very well, considerably very well in terms of being a scholar, a lawyer. But in terms of politics, you don't have that critical mass that knows you. The last thing the Kenyans probably know about you is when you are portrayed by the Moi government as a madman. And that is not very useful.
I think we are shifting into the new era of politics.
Yes.
And with the new kind of social strategies and with the new era of new thinking, the issue of followers of populism does not arise. It might have arisen in those particular time for the people you mentioned because there was a need at that particular time. If you look at me, and as I mentioned before, if you look at what we have done abroad, we are remembered with what we have done and what we stood for. I stood firm when a minister was murdered in this country, and I said no to a lot of things, including bribery. And I suffered for all these years outside the country in a different category, because I was a policeman, I was not that important that particular time. And from that time, there's no politician who has been murdered in this country. That's a contribution I made for this country. And having been outside the country also, as I mentioned again, I've managed single-handedly and also joined others later on to bring in people like Koigi wa Wamwere, who people could not associate with. People like Dr. Liki, who had just broken his legs. People like Honorable Dennis Akumu, who was a vocal person. So by standing to bring in those people with what I've suffered and what my people have suffered from, does not really mean that I have to have a mass to follow me. Judge me by what I am and by what I say and by what I stand for, rather than judging me with whoever is following me. After all, most of those people you mentioned had a mass following, but what did they do? Some of them became the worst crooks in this world, but I don't want to go into the crooked part of it because I'm not here to point names at people who did well. But if you look at my homecoming recently, there were 130,000 people. It was on TV. I was away for all those years. What did that mean to me? That meant they were remembering who I was. That has given me some kind of hope that if I'm given the opportunity in this country, especially by the media, because the media has been a lot of like, he's a young man, though I'm 52, he's just coming, he's a debutant. No, I'm just a Kenyan, like any other person.
Have you set up a campaign secretariat? Or
well, that's another point.
What political party are you going to go with?
I have a political party, but I'm going to court today, because the registrar of political parties has failed to uphold the statute. We petitioned her and actually put in an application for our political party. And for the last 30 days, which ended on 29th, she did not communicate to us. We have gone to that office so many times. We've wasted a lot of resources sleeping, I mean, paying for accommodation here and there. And she was inactive. I'm not here to condemn her, but if I apply the methods or the legal language, particularly where somebody is under statutory obligation to provide, and the person becomes inactive in that case, does not correspond, especially where human rights are concerned, then that person is abusing the constitution.
I hope you know the requirements to register a political party.
We know that. We registered.
Which is what?
One of it is you have to have a name.
Yes.
And that name has to be, you have to pay 500 Kenya shillings to search for the name, which we paid, searched for the name, and we got the name. Then she asked us to pay 100,000, which we paid, and she gave us a letter of authority authenticating our name. And that was on the 29th of the other month. So by statute, she was supposed to give us a provisional certificate within 30 days, which she has.
Isn't it a requirement also that you should have a number of people from every...
Yes, under the old act, political, under the Societies Act.
Yes.
Yes, the law requires you to have at least 200 people in every province, now county.
Yes.
But under the new political act, which became effective only last week.
And the new Political Parties Act?
Yeah, it became effective.
What is the requirement?
The requirement is that you must have at least 1,000 people, members in each and every county.
Do you have that? Is that, do you have that in your list?
We cannot numbers? Have that unless we are given our certificate, a provisional certificate, so that we can go out there and open offices and solicit members. Otherwise, we shall be violating the constitution if we went ahead and did without being given the certificate.
So you need a temporary certificate?
Yes, a provisional certificate, which we have gone to court. In fact, my lawyers, as we speak today, are in court today filing that petition to compel her to give us the certificate.
What about the finances? How do you want to finance your political party and your campaign?
Well, the finances, the act is very clear. The political party is very clear. It says, well, once you register, then you can actually solicit funds from members by membership fee, of which we are going to follow the same methodology. And you shall also ask well-wishers who by then join the party to assist with the party.
But do you have personal resources to sustain a campaign throughout Kenya for your presidential bid?
Well, when Obama started, he didn't have personal resources. But when he started, talked to the people.
But American is very different. In America, people contribute for you to become, to be president. In Kenya, it's the other way around.
No.
For you to be elected?
I'll prove you wrong on that, because when I went to Kenya,
it's the other way around.
When I went to Western Province the other day,
yes,
people contributed for me.
Yes.
They contributed a lot of money. Some of them came up with motorbikes, 1,000 motorbikes from Kakamega to Mumias.
Yes.
Some of them contributed eggs. Some of them contributed cows. So I don't know. Maybe it's the old school, but right now things have changed. Kenyans now are willing to come up and to contribute. I went to Bungoma bus stop, and the border boys there came in and they said, oh, he's here. This is the Ouko man. They carried me, and even they gave me 10,000 Kenya shillings contribution. So things have changed. It depends on how you talk with the people. But if you come in the way I can see these other politicians using the money they have stolen from Kenyans to induce Kenyans to vote for them, then I will not go that direction. If I'm given money for the campaign, definitely I will have to follow the constitution and the laid down procedures to show where that money had come from. Accountability, transparency leads to integrity.
Do you have a system of human beings? I mean, like a running mate, supporters across the country?
Well, what I can say right now is we have not reached there yet until we get our provisional certificate. And once we get it, then we shall cross the bridge.
Mr. Njakoya, thank you very much. We are run out of time.
Thank you very much, sir.
Stay tuned. A very interesting person, from a street boy to president. We'll be back.
Thank you.